Birmingham, Alabama. We are here out at Regions Field. See if we can get a little bit of sign up in there. Coming to you here for Broken Bat Media, our first stop on this road trip to the National Sports Collectors Convention. Got the Birmingham Barons going up against the Tennessee Smokies tonight, a pair of Chicago affiliates in the AA Southern League. See how we do on the inside. Great start pregame on the graphing. We have a quick look through the book here. We've got Luis Alexander Basabi on a card. Got a pair out of Alex Call. A trio from Keon Barnum. Zach Collins on one. I actually pulled the photo on that one, so really cool to get that one signed. Jameson Fisher will try to flip that sideways. There you go, old Jameson Fisher there. See here, we got Tito Polo, we got Trey Michalshewski, got a couple cards there by Dylan Cease, six of them right there by Dane Dunning, pair out of Jake Johansson there as well, and I think, we got these last ones here, got a strength and conditioning coach Tim Rodmaker, and a pair of Richard Dotson as well. So yeah, there you go. Pretty nice start to the night here as about to get a Tennessee end of the inning there, actually. I thought I saw the runner coming around, but there you go. Back a little bit more. Solid food options going on here in Birmingham. A little chicken and waffles action right there. And the Magic City Dog got a sausage there with, I believe it said coleslaw, some kind of barbecue sauce. A little mustard. We'll let you know how it is. All right, Arron, what's the verdict on the hot dog there?
It's pretty good. I like the coleslaw. It adds a little bit of crunch along with a little bit of sweetness to it. Overall, I'd say B+.
There you go, B+. I really can't argue with that. Last stop in Birmingham before we hit the road, Rickwood Field, oldest baseball park in the country. Used in several movies, home of the Birmingham Barons. A lot of legendary players have played at this ballpark. Under construction right now, unfortunately, we can't go inside, but you can at least see the facade here and the generic scene here outside of the ballpark. So there you go, Rickwood Field, Birmingham, Alabama. Whitaker Bank Ballpark, Lexington, Kentucky, stop number 2 on our trip, and it's behind the bushes. We'll get you a better view of it here in a few, but got the Rome Braves and the Lexington Legends going at it tonight. That's the A-level teams for the Atlanta Braves and the Kansas City Royals. See in a few moments on the inside. There we go, much better view from here inside of the bushes there. As I said, Whitaker Bank Ballpark, Lexington, Kentucky. Got a nice little wall of fame going on right here with the Lexington Legends. You might see a few names on there you recognize. A few former legends right there that made it to the majors. Delino DeShields being one of them. Raul Mondesi, sons of former major leaguers. Miguel Almonte, of course, on there as well. Hunter Dozier, you may see his name right there. Several former and current Astros, J.D. Martinez, one of the big names there. Jose Altuve, of course, you see him right there. You may have heard in between talking there that Rome Braves just got on the board with a home run. Mitch Talbot, future one of my Cleveland Indians right there. Move on down this way. Check that one out right there. Roger Clemens pitched a little bit here with Lexington. And of course, they also have the South Atlantic League Player of the Week honors. See Hunter Pence, Jose Altuve, J.D. Martinez. Number of big names right on there. We're going to get some footage from inside the park here in a moment as well. Out here in the outfield here for the bottom of the first, the Lexington Legends just tied it up, actually, off of a double to center. Got Sully Matias to the plate right now. Let's watch the at-bat. Let's see what he can do here. Up, stealing third. He hits this one in the air toward right. That's going to fall in. Fair ball. That'll have to hold him up, and Sully's got caught in a rundown here. Runner's heading home. Runner is going to be out by half a mile, it looks like, and Matias will advance to second base. So Matias not quite able to extend the rundown long enough to get the runner home, but he's in at second base at least. I believe that is the second out of the inning. So there you go, get a little view out here in Lexington. A little quick panoramic swipe. Here, a quick update on the autographing from before the game. Mitch Stetter, pitching coach, did three cards right there. Side one each from Colin Snyder, Jeffrey Del Rosario, Christian Perez, Yancer Lara, Ricky Arosena. Move on to the next page here. Sal Biasi and Carlos Hernandez are among the pregame signers out on the concourse, so got those guys before they even got on the field. Also one each from Sebastian Rivero and Martin Gasparini, and right there, one of the big prospects in the Royals organization, Nick Prado, signing four cards. And last but not least, biggest one I think for me so far here, Sully Matias, another top prospect right there for the Royals, signed two cards I had of him. See if we can get a few more after the game as well. All right, so food here in Lexington, not quite what we had in Birmingham last night, but I was looking forward to a couple things. I mean, they had a 3-foot kebab, but the kebab place is closed. And even if it had been open, it was $30. So, no, that didn't happen. I'd heard something about a fried bologna sandwich. No fried bologna anywhere, but they did have these. Mac and cheese brisket bombs. So, we're going to give those a try. We're going to see how those end up, and get your review here in just a few moments after I wolf one of these things down. All right, Lexington. We've got a little bit of an issue here. Zoom in, Aaron. Let's see what we got here. As you see, I've already eaten one of those balls. Now, here's the thing. These things came fresh out of the deep fryer. Watch this. I can press my finger into there and I'm not in any pain. That is cold in the middle. Like refrigerator cold in the middle. That's not good. I mean, I stood in line and it's 2.5 innings of the game waiting for this. And it's cold. Yeah, that doesn't fly with me. That's we're going to talk about this off camera. Aaron gave it a D minus, and I don't think I can argue with that. Aaron, any further comments there?
I don't think so.
All right, there you go. So, well, hopefully we got West Virginia coming tomorrow. Hopefully the South Atlantic League can redeem itself tomorrow. West Virginia, land of cheese. I don't know, it's West Virginia. I don't know if they have cheese or not. I don't think they do. But yeah, West Virginia looks a lot like Eastern Kentucky, as Aaron was pointing out as we started this clip. I think that's going to get edited out, though, but yeah. So, yeah, we're coming up on Huntington, West Virginia, as you probably see by that sign right there. We've got about an hour, less than an hour, until we are into Charleston and at the ballpark there, so we'll see you over on that side. Ooh, hey, there's a bridge. Warehouse building at the ballpark here in Charleston, West Virginia. A quick shot up Lewis Street here. You can see a little bit of the ballpark peeking out right there. So we're going to be headed here in a few moments. We're going to have the West Virginia Power hosting the Asheville Tourists, game number 3 of the trip. Right outside the entrance here of Appalachian Power Park. Just a few hours from being able to get in. Let's see if we can find ourselves the team shop, see if it's still open right now. Go get our card sets and get ready to grab it. Okay, so I'm an idiot. We're 2 pitches into the game with that one. First pitch went for an O'Neill Cruz home run out to right field there. So try to get it to him later on. But there you go, get an idea of the field here from the inside. Once again, Appalachian Power Park here in Charleston, West Virginia. Back the other way now. And we'll stick around for at least part of this at bat. Lolo Sanchez at the plate. He takes a strike, 1-2 count. Sanchez hitting .233 on the year. 3 homers, 26 RBI for him with 21 steals. It was the wind and the pitch. Takes low. Runs count to 2-2. Once again, the wind and the delivery. This one grounded on the infield. Shortstop taking care of this one. Quick throw over to first and nearly beating it out. Just barely got him. Sanchez showing off the wheels there, but got one away here in the bottom of the first inning. Get you a quick look at the autographs from pregame here as well. Got Cody Bolton on the game program there. Hope we can get Dion Stafford after the game. Get through the cards real quick here as well. Across the top row there we have got Rodolfo Castro, Matt Seelinger, the aforementioned Lolo Sanchez, and Kyle Watson. Down across the bottom here, Sergio Cubilete, Calvin Mitchell, Domingo Robles, and Ryan Purifoy, who you may have just heard his name announced in the background. Across the top there, we've got Coach Norberto Martin signing 4 cards for me from the Asheville Tourists. Across the bottom there, Argenis Diaz, and then 3 out of Joel Hanrahan, former Major League All-Star pitcher right there. Right over on the side here, I get everything focused here. It's kind of tough in the sun here. But we've got Tommy Doyle on a pair of cards. Then 3 and 6 from Wyatt Torregas, former Cleveland Indians catcher, played with the Lake County Captains for a while, who we'll be seeing on Tuesday. And there you have it. Once again, coming to you here from Charleston, West Virginia. Okay, let's try this again. We've got O'Neill Cruz batting, one of the Pirates' top prospects. Shortstop, 6'6", big guy there. Foul the first one off, takes this one for a strike as it's 0-2. 2-out runner at third. He's got the only run of the game, hit a home run to lead things off in the bottom half of the first. Up here in the bottom of the second, the 0-2 pitch, he lines this one up the middle off the shortstop and into right field. Base hit, that'll score a run. It's 2-0. O'Neill Cruz responsible for both of those runs. That's what I say. Okay, that was the second baseman, not the shortstop, but yeah. You get the idea. That's what I'm going for. Look, I'm trying to view this from an alternate angle, okay?
Batting now for the power of the center.
Aaron's giving grief over there about that one.
Sanchez.
So there you go. A little more action here from Charleston. So if anybody could hear on my previous clip there, this dude is sitting down there just heckling the hell out of any opposing player. He's got notes there that he's reading off of. This is absolutely amazing. And yes, that is a toaster right next to him. Apparently when there's an 0-2 count on a batter or a two strike count, he'll start making toast. And up on the scoreboard, if he strikes out, he gets this UR toast and he'll toss out toast to the nearby people. Gotta love minor league baseball. Columbus, Ohio. Got some AAA baseball here tonight. Day four of the trip. Columbus Clippers will be playing at home. They're going to be taking on the Indianapolis Indians. AAA squads for the Indians and the Pirates, respectively. Blue Jackets can't win a game. Yes, that's right, Nationwide Arena. That's where we're at right now. See if I can get some of this in there. Kind of a large building, not exactly the best angle on it here, but see kind of the outside of it there. Indianapolis Indians taking batting practice here in Columbus. See if we can get him actually hitting one here. There we go. A couple more. A little taste of the major leagues here in Columbus. Andrew Miller coming in to pitch here for the Clippers on a little rehab assignment. It'll be Kevin Kramer, the first batter here. We'll keep it here and watch this at bat. First pitch slider for a strike. Kramer 0 for 1 in the game. He's got a hit by pitch thus far. And struck out looking in the fourth. Second pitch by Miller fouled straight back and all the way out of the park. As is quickly 0-2. Kramer on the year hitting 292, 11 homers, 46 RBI. Set by Miller and the pitch. This one's skied out toward the outfield over there in right. Under it for the catch. And there's one away. So there you go. Andrew Miller in a rehab start, or rehab appearance, I should say, out here at Huntington Park, Columbus, Ohio. East Lake, Ohio, just on the other side of Ohio Route 91 here in the parking lot outside of Classic Park. You'll see the Lake County Captains and the Great Lakes Loons here this morning on 11 a.m. Eastern Time start. They'll be rolling two games today. Going to be going here, and they'll be out in Toledo, about a two-hour drive away a little bit later on tonight. But first, a little bit of Midwest League action coming your way. East Lake, Ohio, Classic Park. As he takes the ball high, we've got the Lake County Captains, A-ball for the Cleveland Indians, and the Great Lakes Loons, A-ball for the L.A. Dodgers. Stick around for an at-bat here. Cardi winds and fires. That one's lined toward the shortstop. He'll make the grab. And we finally have one away. 2-0 already here in the top of the first. We'll bring you a little more later. Well, you can probably tell post-game graphing not happening tonight. Got some rain coming here. 3-2 game. Captains end up losing it. But getting some changes in the plans there. So no Toledo tonight. No post-game graphing here in Lake County. But we'll be back at you again. The National starts tomorrow, Wednesday night. We'll have a report from you, a report for you from the IX Center once we get in tomorrow afternoon. IX Center, Cleveland, Ohio, first day of the National Sports Collectors Convention. Heading over to the entrance right now. See you on the other side. Day one of the National Sports Collectors Convention in the books. Back here again tomorrow morning. Finally get a bigger look at a lot of the tables. We just got to went through our autograph lines and checked out some of the corporate pavilions. You see Panini right back in there. Of course, you got Topps and Upper Deck around as well, plus eBay, PSA, Beckett, Ripping Wax, Dave and Adams, you name it, they're here. Biggest event in the sports collectibles hobby every year. We also get you a quick look right there. The formerly the world's tallest indoor Ferris wheel. We'll be getting a report from that a little bit later on in the week as well. So once again, Cleveland, Ohio National Sports Collector Convention coming to you here all week. All right, so I haven't been doing a whole lot of video from here at the National, but decided today had a little extra money. We're going to go and get in on some of the various redemptions that they have. So the box of his TriStar Touchdown Treasure. As you see, it has one autographed football mini helmet in each box. We got a chance to win some extra stuff there as well. Tickets redeemable for some autographed mem. It's the first time that I've ever gotten one of these before, but see some big names on there with Deshaun Watson, Ryan Bosworth, Alvin Kamara, Sam Darnold, Saquon Barkley, Tom Brady. Who knows what might be in here? We're going to give it a shot. All right, so we finally got that box open up. Let's see what's inside. OU player, and it looks like we have Brian Bosworth there as our player on the helmet. And there you have it. So yeah, Brian Bosworth is our mini helmet in here, so that'll go over big there among a lot of people there. Is heading back down to North Texas, a lot of split there between OU fans and UT fans, so see what we might be able to trade that for at some point. I have a little bit more for you here later on. Got two more boxes I picked up and got some redemption packs to go along with those. Oh, by the way, the TriStar redemption, unfortunately only got a pack of, I believe it was 2007 TriStar baseball prospects, so who knows, maybe we'll see if we can get something out of there too. But there you have it, our first break of the video here. All right, so back at the hotel. I think it's about time maybe we... It's a little bit of box breaking. So we showed earlier the mini helmet there that we got from TriStar. Turned out to be Brian Bosworth in there. So I think next we're going to start breaking out some of these bonus packs. Now, they had a deal there at the various dealers, or excuse me, at the various card manufacturers. Tops, if you bought a box of Pro Debut, which was the most useful to me, you get one silver pack. We're going to take a look at that. I've already opened it up there because, let's be honest, when I'm holding my phone here, it's kind of hard to open it with just one hand. So we'll do that one here in a moment. Probably show you the highlights of the Pro Debut box as well. I also picked up some a couple Playbook Hockey boxes from, I believe this was, what is this, 13-14, somewhere around there, but got two of those boxes there just because it's a product that I've worked on a bit, so it'd be fun to get to check that out. And also a box of Donruss Racing. That brought me five Panini packs right there, which was the second most you could get from anything and the only one for that low of a price that would get you that many packs. So it's like, well, hey, why not? I mean... I do some racing TTMs, so let's check those out. So I think we'll go in order here. Oh, and by the way, as I mentioned with the TriStar mini helmet there, I also got that out of my mystery bag, so we'll check that out as well. But let's start out with that Topps silver pack, if we can. Go through real quick here, and the four that we got are the specially marked Bowman Chrome with the National logo on them right there. And as you see, the first one there is Eloy Jimenez. Follow that up with Alex Verdugo. Also a Manny Machado. Two guys that are about to be teammates once Verdugo gets called back up. And an orange Mitch Keller one. Got to see him just a couple weeks ago. That one is numbered on the back. See if you can get in there close enough. And that's 3 out of 25. So pretty solid one right there on that Mitch Keller one. Arron, your thoughts?
Good, Mitch Keller.
Yeah, exactly.
Nice dude.
Yeah. So, I'm going to pause for just a moment here. We're going to put that aside, and then next up, we're going to go over to these Panini packs. All right, so we've got five Panini packs here. Varying thicknesses on them as well. Got three of them that are fairly thin, one's kind of a medium thickness, and one that is very thick. But as you see right there, we've got the Matthew Stafford card in there. And the DJ Moore, which is autographed, an on-card auto. I believe that may be signed at the rookie photo shoot. Correct me if I'm wrong, but that is a possibility. Very nice. Very happy with that one. Pack number two, another one of the thinner ones. Pull those out. There we go. Got a ball player here, a baseball player, I should say. That's Paul Goldschmidt right off the top on that one. And NASCAR driver Austin Dillon. Right, thin pack number three. Got Giancarlo Stanton. And also Jimmy Garoppolo. I believe that is, yeah, it's in his college jersey there, Eastern Illinois. Let's go for that medium thick one right here. At least it felt kind of medium thick. Looks like it's got something special in there. We've got a George Springer off the top. And right here, a Gary Trent Jr. That is a Panini Prospects insert in there. Hence the slightly additional thickness to it. And finally, the thick pack there. I think that one might have some kind of a jersey type of card in it. Show you that here in a second. The first one is going to be the James Harden base card. And Colton Miller of the Raiders. I believe that is a piece of the jersey that he is holding up at the draft. Number 18 out of 49. Show you the back of that as well. And yes, the enclosed hat presented to Colton Miller on stage is guaranteed by Panini America. So, piece of his draft hat in the card right there. So, pretty cool one right there. As a gigantic draft geek, I totally approve of that. And so, there you go. We'll come back a little bit later on with some of the highlights from those boxes of Pro Debut, Donruss Racing, and Panini Playbook. All right, and take a look through that pro debut box. It's a fun one to open. Going to be able to get a few of these signed, hopefully, but got a few parallels at least to start off. We've got Hans Kraus of the Rangers. That one is, let's turn that the right way, numbered 97 out of 99. It's the green parallel. Also got a Ryan Mountcastle. That is the Leaps and Bounds insert. Those ones are getting a green Leaps and Bounds is one in every 121 packs, so I'm definitely happy with that one. It is numbered 91 out of 99. Also got Braden Bishop on there as well. Green parallel, that is numbered 46 out of 99. So three parallels in there, not too bad. We also got two autos as guaranteed per box. First one is Mark Vientos, a Mets prospect. Another one is Brendan Rodgers, the top prospect in the Rockies organization. Subject of trade rumors for a little while there, but fortunately for him, still part of the Rocks org, and actually just moved up to AAA last week. Two mem cards as well. Very happy with these ones. Of course, the Royce Lewis pro debut with the pro debut patch right there. Commemorative patch made specifically for it, but still, it's Royce Lewis. I'm very happy with that. And the biggest one out of any of these, Fragments of the Farm, Tim Tebow. So overall, quite a fun box to break there, and I have to look into getting another one at some point. All right, so we've gone through the playbook packs. We'll show you what we got here. Let's go right down the line. First off, we got a redemption for Mikhail Grigorenko, first round edition. I mean, auto, I believe. Bo Bennett, first drafts, yeah, Penguins. I actually used to call Bo Bennett's brother's hockey games back when he was playing juniors. Rick Tocchet, social signatures. Braden Schenn, social signatures. I always like Tocchet, so I'm happy with that. Schenn's pretty good, too. Base cards on Oliver Ekman-Larsson and Jonathan Quick. And then we get the booklets. We'll start with the Split Decisions, English, I can speaking. That is Steve Mason right there. This one I actually pulled the photos on, so I'm really happy to get one of those and get to see it. It's got him doing the split save right there. Two big jersey pieces. And then over on the other side here, numbered, as you can see, 8 out of 100, Logan Couture signature booklet. Take a look at that. Great signature there, big jersey swatch. I think I may have pulled the photos in that one, too. So definitely happy with those two boxes there. Those were a couple fun ones to look through. So once again, that is, I believe, 2013-14. Yes, 13-14 Panini Playbook Hockey. All right, here in Akron, got some decent autographs before the game. We'll go through those real quick. Four right there out of Mitch Brown. Got one right there from Sam Haggerty. There you go.
Peanut, Cracker Jack, cotton candy.
Rob Kaminsky signing two up top there. Logan Ice with the two right down there. Also got James Karinchak right there. The last one I needed to complete the Lake County Quad, so that was great getting that one. Got two from Tyler Krieger right there. One from Kieran Lovegrove. A full four right there out of Mark Mathias. Got two of Joe Sever. Got a pair right there from Ka'ai Tom. Two from Matt Whitehouse. And we got the trainer there as well, Paul Sinenkai, I believe is how it's pronounced. I could be totally wrong on that, but there you go. The full report on the autographs here in Akron. See what we can do post-game. So Akron's got a heck of a menu here for the extreme food. Just going to give you a quick rundown of everything here. We're going to come away with one of these for sure here in a moment, but got the Not Your Routine poutine, the Three Dog Night, which is a kielbasa split in half with a bratwurst inside, split in half with a hot dog inside of it, with sauerkraut on a sub bun. That sounds pretty good right there.
It is.
Thank you, Christian.
Editing. You can edit me out.
Yeah, that's not going to happen.
Oh.
I don't have that capability, I don't think.
Adobe Premiere or something?
I just go with whatever I've got on my computer. I mean, this is, I'm running a fly-by-night operation here for sure on this, so. Anyways, so looking at through the rest of this, the Screamer, 21 scoops of ice cream and a whole bunch of other stuff. That sounds pretty good. Sounds pretty big, too. La Montagna, this big mountain of salami and pepperoni and all this other stuff. That sounds good, too. The Nice to Meet You Burger, the Pineapple Terry Akron Bowl, the Thanks Joe, the Notorious P.I.G., the Squealer. I don't know what I'm going to go with yet, but yeah, that's a heck of a menu right there. So we'll figure that out. You'll get to see it whenever I decide. Martin Cervenka to the plate here in the second inning. Let's watch as it bat. Takes first pitch strike, 89 miles an hour on that one. There we go. Get everybody in there. Miles an hour on that one. Ball one. Chops this one toward first base. Rodriguez up with it, flips it on, and retires him for the second out of the inning. So well, there we go. A little bit of action here from Akron.
I may have just made the biggest mistake of my life. What you see in front of me is something called the Notorious P.I.G., and I'm going to try to eat this.
What it consists of is it's a larger than life, according to the game program, it's a larger than life sandwich with two fried pork tenderloins as the bun.
Which
is then piled high with a stack of pulled pork, the Conwood's smoked shoulder bacon, and maple honey mustard sauerkraut slaw. Looks like some hot sauce of some kind on top. We'll get a sample of that.
Pretty good, a little hot sauce on there.
It's so big, it requires two forks and two knives, and I may need to grow a second mouth and a second stomach as well, but it looks both scary and majestic at the same time.
I don't know what you got going on here, but that looks like a health code violation, and you should probably get a second one for free.
Hey, she went two for two. We'll give it to her. Good job, Adriana. We're going to send you right back up to DJ.
I'm about to try this out. I will see you on the other side.
Send prayers.
All right, I'm about halfway in and feeling all right. Meanwhile, across the table. Aaron, what do you got here? Tell us about this.
It's called the Nice to Meet You Burger. It is three all beef patties, two sliced bratwurst, then there's bacon, and there's supposed to be some onions on there, whatever. We're going to eat it regardless.
How much cheese we got there? Is that three slices?
Yeah, so we got three.
Wow.
Three slices of cheese.
All right.
That's right. So, we're going to knock this thing out.
There you have it. Food in Akron. I got to give this, at least this huge, the Notorious P.I.G. here, I got to give that an A. That is a solid chunk of meat right there. Aaron, what do you got for this?
I will go A as well. This is the best I've had this whole trip.
There you have it. Akron, well done.
I tried. I got most of the way through. But in the case of man versus food, food has won this round.
You know how you got to finish this off? No. Just be like... Let it roll out of your hands.
I've still got energy. I haven't like completely died yet. The end. Now the end.
But we're here for the flair. We're here for the clickbait.
No, we're not. I have not yet died, but the angioplasty is scheduled for tomorrow. So that's really important right there. So
if you're accepting the fact that you're gonna die in the next blank hours, milk it.
No.
I tried.
So there you have it. Food in Akron, incredible.
Eastlake, Ohio, Lake County captains our second game out here at Classic Park of the trip. So I'm going to see the Bowling Green Hot Rods as the opponent, the A-level team for the Tampa Bay Rays. Take a quick look here. We'll give you the rundown of pregame autographs in there. One of the Tribe's top prospects right there, Will Benson, signing 1 out of 2. Let's see here. We got 3 out of coach Kyle Hudson. 1 out of outfielder Todd Isaacs. So 1 from pitcher Felix Tati. Team trainer Juan Acevedo. And over on the other side from Bowling Green, 1 from pitching coach Brian Reith. 5 right there from coach Manny Castillo. And 1 from outfielder Taylor Walls. Not sure if Drew Strotman is there or not. He's on the DL right now, but we did see Mikey York, so we'll hopefully be able to get him post-game. But there you go, not too bad for our second game of the season here between, well, second game of the season involving the Lake County Captains. See if we can add to that post-game. Gabriel Mejia leading things off for the Captains. He bunts one right back to the mound. That didn't quite go as planned. And there's out number 1. I was going to stick around for one at bat. We'll stick around for a second one here. Give me J.J. Berardi up second.
Number 17, J.J. Berardi.
Berardi's second baseman is hitting .235 on the year. 2 homers, 13 RBI. Wind and the pitch. Takes inside for a ball. Pitch number 2 at the at-bat takes for a strike, and it's 1-1. One nothing right now. Hot Rods on top. A double and a single to lead things off. That one fouled back by Berardi. Makes it a 1-2 count. So Mejia with the bunt out to the pitcher to start things off. Berardi second will be Vicente on deck. Gonzalez third if either Berardi or Vicente can get on base. The wind down the pitch. This one is grounded along the infield. Goes to right to the second baseman. He'll turn, throw to first in time, and there's out number 2. So let's get a little bit of live action for you here from Classic Park in Eastlake, Ohio, home of the A-ball Lake County Captains in the Midwest League.
The designated hitter, number 15, Jose Vicente.
Well, we're here in the top of the third. 1 out and the bases are loaded for the Hot Rods. Their cleanup hitter, Ronaldo Hernandez, coming to the plate. 0-1 so far in this game. On the season, hitting .294, 18 homers, 69 RBI. Got a chance to add to that right here. Looking in, coming set. Line down the pitch is in the dirt for ball 1. 3-1 our score right now. Captains came away with 3 in the bottom of the second to take the lead. 2 errors by each team thus far. We're only, like I said, in the top of the third here, so not a whole lot of gloves out on the field. Another one in the dirt, and it's 2-0. Unfortunately, can't quite see the batter here. Up now, there we go. The set and the pitch. Just off the plate, 3-0. Now do you give him the green light here with the bases loaded? Line and the pitch, and they do give him the green light. Line straight to short. All runners back safely, though. 2 away. And a very loud out there for the second out of the inning. Progressive Field, Cleveland, Ohio. We are here. Final game in Ohio for us. We're making our way back out to Indiana tomorrow. A view of the Cleveland skyline there once again. Gotta love that view from down here. Once again, Indians and Angels coming to you 7 p.m. tonight. Progressive Field, Cleveland, Ohio, here before the game this time for the Cougar Board. So we're going to take a quick look at this. This is from a place called Happy Dog. Aaron, just go ahead and pan in on that. We've got ourselves called the Dingus Dog. It's a hot dog topped with pierogies with some red cabbage and horseradish sauce as well. Heard a lot of good things about Happy Dog. I'm definitely anxious to try this out. So we'll get you to board here in a moment. We'll get this right here and see what you think. Pretty big, pretty good size here. There we go. All right. That is good.
McDonald's.
Oh, that is really good. There goes Cleveland food so far. Skips thumbs up for me. So I'll give you the view from center field here for one at bat. It's going to be Shohei Ohtani at the plate. On the mound, Corey Kluber. Try to zoom in a bit here and see what we can do. Ohtani hitting 272 on the season. Kluber winds and fires. This one's low for a ball. 11 home runs. Has not been pitching much lately after having some elbow troubles for a bit in the season. Two out here in the top of the first as Kluber goes into his windup and delivers. This one comes in high for a ball. Line out and a strikeout here before Ohtani came to the plate. Kluber looks in. Now winds and fires. This one swung on and chopped foul first baseline to the Angels dugout. And it's a 1-2 count on Ohtani. Albert Pujols waits on deck, followed by Andrelton Simmons if Ohtani can get on base. Kluber winds and fires. This one outside for a ball. Goes 2-2. Infield swung around way to the right, as you see over there. Second baseman playing deep on the grass. That is Kipnis there. Lindor at short. Kluber winds and fires. Swung on and missed. Now it's a 2-2 count. Here's I was off by one. It's actually 3-2 now at this point. Ball in the first pitch. Kluber goes into his windup and the pitch. Got him looking. Ends the inning. Kluber two strikeouts here in the first. Tribe comes to bat in the bottom of the first. top 100 players in team history, all with autographed bricks back here. Meanwhile, those have plaques for several famous players. We'll show you those in a moment. As you can see, off to the far left there is the Ray Chapman Memorial. Back over on the right, they have one for Louis Sakalexis. As we turn around, right across here, the entire Team Hall of Fame in Cleveland. Plaques for a lot of greats, as Al Rosen is right there. Down there, Shoeless Joe Jackson. Albert Bell. Great Andre Thornton. Kenny Lofton. Keep on moving down here, we get Herb Score. Rocky Colavito. Omar Vizquel. Mike Hargrove. Steve O'Neill. Carlos Baerga. Charles Nagy. Sandy Alomar Jr. Hal Trosky. One of my favorites, Mel Harder, should be in the Hall of Fame. Ken Keltner. And Mike Garcia. Sudden Sam McDowell. Jim Hegan. Charlie Jameson. Wes Farrell. And of course, Ray Chapman. More plaques up top. We'll show you those here in just a moment. Now some of the big names. And now some of the big names here in the Team Hall of Fame. We get Nap Lajoie. Larry Doby. Lou Boudreau. And Bob Feller over here. Bob Lemon. Chris Speaker. Earl Averill. Satchel Paige. Don't look back, something might be gaining on you. Over on this side, we get Elmer Flick. And the newest Hall of Famer, Jim Thome.
There you go, right here.
The great Gaylord Perry. Stan Kovaleski.
There you go, Stan Kovaleski.
Joe Sewell. And another Joe and Joe Gordon. Al Lopez. Of course, there is Cy Young. Possibly the greatest pitcher of all time that no one's heard of, Addie Joss. Frank Robinson. And on the last plaques, we have Jesse Burkitt. And early win. Union's Hall of Fame here in Heritage Plaza at Progressive Park. Here in Fort Wayne, Indiana for this game, Parkview Field. As you just saw, a base hit right there. As you can see right now, top of the third inning, 3-1, the Tin Caps leading the Lansing Lugnuts. Well, right, we'll bring you a bat right here.
Jeremy and I worked for that.
Scheckler on the mound with Samad Taylor to the plate. Runner first, one out. Yeah, down right there. There we go. Trying to keep the crowd out of that. As he comes set, quick look at first. He'll throw over, runner back. Ruiz, the runner at first, just got on with the single that you saw there as the clip here started. Again, Scheckler comes set. There goes the runner. Taking all the way, throw down is late. Skips away, but he'll hold at second. So stolen base right there for Ruiz. So runner in scoring position here with one out. Once again here in the top of the third inning. 85 miles an hour on that last pitch as it was taken for a ball to 1-0. Scheckler looking in, taking a long look at the sign, comes set, batter calls time. And we'll try this again. Scheckler comes set, quick check at second. A second look at second. The wind down the pitch. Swung on, big cut, and missed. It's 1-1. Taylor hitting 227 on the season here for the Lansing Lugnuts. Six homers, 40 RBI. And again, Scheckler comes set. Line down the pitch, shows bunt, takes for a ball, it's 2-1. Taylor 1-for-1 already on the day as we're here in the top of the third. Scheckler again looking in, comes set. Quick check at second, the wind down the pitch. This one's in the dirt and it's a 3-1 count. .87 miles an hour on that last one by Scheckler. Most have been hitting the high 80s, it seems, so far. Outfield and infield all playing straight away. Scheckler with a quick check at second. Turns, runner back. Davis on deck, then Downs after that. The 3-1 pitch to Taylor, big cut and a miss, it runs the count full. 87 on the fastball. Decent lead at second for Ruiz. Scheckler sets, quick check and 3-2 delivery. Taking for ball four, and with that, there'll be runners at first and second here with one out in the third. So there you go. There's that bat coming your way from Parkview Field here in Fort Wayne, Indiana. Cedar Rapids, Iowa here on this Monday morning. Got a noon game here. Perfect Game Field, Veterans Memorial Stadium, home of the Cedar Rapids Colonels. Going to see them taking on the Beloit Snappers, a little bit more Midwest League action. See if we can graph the inside, see if we can watch a game inside. Hope this rain holds off. Got a little bit this morning, a little bit last night. Hope it stays nice and clear, though. And so here we are inside the stadium in Cedar Rapids, about to get this game underway. Cloudy skies here. Raindrops falling early on. They seem to have dried up a bit. Now we'll get your first pitch right here. As is Nick Allen stepping into the box. 217 hitter on the season. First pitch of the game, a called strike on the fastball. 95 miles an hour on that one. First pitch, 12:07 officially. Line of the pitch, swing and a miss, and quickly 0-2 here on Allen to start things out. Allen, Armenteros, and Beck due up in this inning. Operating quickly, the wind and the pitch, swing and a miss, strike three. First strikeout of the game. And bringing a little bit of action here from Cedar Rapids, we'll have a little bit more later on. From Des Moines, Iowa, Principal Park, home of the Iowa Cubs, AAA squad for, of course, the Chicago Cubs, taking on the Las Vegas 51s Mets AAA team here. Give you a quick update on the autographs a little bit later on. I'll try to bring you in one at bat of play-by-play if we can as well. At right now, Ty Kelly, the shortstop. He's 0 for 2 in the game so far. Possibly 0 for 3. They don't have his first at bat up there. Runners to the corners for him with 2 out, 0-1 count right now. Wyman, the pitch comes in low, and it's 1-1. Kelly hitting 268 on the year, 8 home runs, and 43 RBI. It's James Norwood entering the game just now on the mound for the Cubs. He winds and delivers that one low for a ball. It's 2-1. Of course, we don't have the best angle for you here, but we'll try to get you as much as we can. Norwood's pitched 10 innings with the Iowa Cubs here this season. 1.80 ERA, 13 strikeouts in that time. So that pitch comes in outside, 3-1 count now on the shortstop Kelly. Got one run in this inning. It's a 4-1 lead right now for Las Vegas. We're in the top of the eighth inning. Norwood looks in, now comes set. 3-1 delivery, swung on and hit toward left field. That's going to go, does stay fair as it bounces off the wall. One run in, looks like a second one will score as well. So an RBI double right there for Ty Kelly makes this a 6-1 game. Bring us some action once again here from Principal Park in Des Moines, Iowa. We'll be right back.